What is up, guys? Welcome back to episode 3 of Gumption. Today is Monday. I'm starting my week 2 of getting ready for Open Nationals 2022 up on the Gold Coast on October 14th and 16th. Got my primary squats today again. Looking for something around an 8 RPE single followed by an 8 RPE double. Thinking in mind around about that 235 mark, just to take safe jumps off last week. Other than that, today I've just been programming for the team. We've got the junior, sub-junior and masters nationals this weekend in Melbourne. So fair bit going on. I also had a novice comp over the weekend that we hosted at HPC, and we had about 15 HPC athletes competing. So today was spent writing a bunch of new programs, writing tapers and getting ready for obviously the competition this weekend that is going to be really, really fun. We're taking you guys down to Melbourne with me on the camera. We'll be heading down Thursday morning, I think. I'm not sure, I have to double check. And we'll be staying out near the facility. So no doubt we'll get some cool footage of the team smashing it. We've got lifters across all weight classes, so and categories actually, so it'll be really fun. But right now I'm still in my working outfit. So I've got to go and get changed and get ready to go to the gym. Like I said, I've been programming this morning since like 9, and then I've only really had brunch. So I'm going to have another feed as my pre-workout, and I'll be on my way. All right, so I'll see you guys there. John's clearly excited about it, aren't you, boy? Not really. All right, see you guys soon. So I thought that may as well show you guys what I'm eating before I go to the gym. And typically this is something that I eat every single day, but it just depends on how big it is. And that depends on what I ate before it. So Mondays are really busy for me. I'm writing all my program updates for my guys. I'm doing check-ins, and it usually goes for about 6 to 7 hours. And then it leads into the night and then Tuesday, and then it fizzles out towards the end of the week. But Mondays are always busy. Some days I get just my breakfast in, some days I get breakfast and lunch in, depending on it. But today is just one of those days where obviously writing a lot of programs for the guys that compete on the weekend, and then writing like individualized tapers for every athlete who are competing this weekend as well. So what I've done is this morning I had a couple of egg and bacon, sandwiches with some veggies, and I haven't had anything since. All I had is just water and a coffee. So I'm gonna make this. Basically what I'm looking for before I train, if I haven't ate much, is some sodium and some good sources of low and high GI glucose. So I've got bagels here, just the Abe's Bakery bagels. They're fantastic. They're about 50 grams of carbs per bagel, really lean, not very fibrous, so it gets absorbed quite quickly, which is great. And then I'm just gonna put a lick of the strawberry jam on top. And then what I'll do is, and all my guys who I coach know this trick, is we're just gonna crack some sodium, some salt over the top. It doesn't have to be anything fancy, just the Himalayan salt if you've got some of that. But just crack that over the top. And then once that's over the top, you just get it in your guts. And then on the way to the gym, I'll be eating one of these suckers. So an apple. And then I'll also take my banana and my two mandarins with me. And then I'll eat that throughout the workout. I am lacking protein at the moment, so I'm probably gonna take this with me. And that will just sit with me in the car. It's just whey protein from bulk nutrients. And I'll basically have a shake of that when I finish my training. So yeah, I'm gonna get sucked into this, and I'll see you guys probably in the car at the gym. All right. So just warm up the squats, I'm gonna do some flamingos like I always do, just to loosen off the hamstrings a little more. And then I'll do some good mornings, basically just to find my flexion. And then that should make it feel nice and flimsy to get up in the bath for some squats. Kel sent through my program, and single at 8, a double at 8, and then some 2x2 after that. So in for a pretty big day, looking for something around 230 to 240 single. See how you go.
Are you doing this work to facilitate growth or to become famous? Which is more important, getting or letting go?
hurtful. Everybody gotta cry once in a while, but how long will it take for you smile? This is that come back to life shit. My niggas pick me up and we gon' light the city up as if the sun had the night shit. And paint the town red for my nigga found dead too soon. Yeah. To the left of that decimal, I need 7 figures to play the joint. Turn up your decibels, pee pie decimator joint. Check out my projects like them workers that section 8 appoints. And you'll see how I flip like exclamation points. My niggas shoot first as if they never played the point. More two guards, enough straps to fill for you U-Haul. More depth than World War II calls around these parts. Sweet Porter Brown just to drown these stalks of black corpses in county morgues. Lord, those images haunting, I ain't been asleep yet. It's 10 in the morning, I'm sending a warning. A problem with me is like the BET Hip Hop Awards. I'm starting to see you niggas don't want it. I'm sick of this flaunting from niggas I know for sure ain't got more dough than cold trash rappers. Ass backwards, trying to go toe to toe, we laugh at ya. Staff strapped up on top the totem pole to blast at ya. Bassmasters, look how they total pole. Gotta know the ropes and a protocol, or they gon' for sure blow your clothes half off like a promo code. Made a little tune called Folding Clothes, and a nigga still ain't on the fold. Under pressure, well, you know what code do. Make a diamond, they just rhyming me, I'm quoting gold. One phone call gets you canceled like a homophobe. In this PC culture, dress me as the GOAT like they call Chief Keef Sosa. In my section, no, like a fucking three-piece sofa. I'm known as the chosen one. Under the dead body lay frozen, that's how it goes sometimes. When niggas wearing coke and not the pros and cons. Well, I ain't with that sleeping underground like a gopher, so I go for mine. Everything come back around full circle. Why do lies sound pleasant but the truth?
So because of the fact that I benched yesterday, being the primary bench day, because I couldn't do it on the day that's supposed to be done on, running the novice comp, it is feeling a little bit harder than usual, but that's expected. So I expect numbers to be down this week, and that's the most important thing, is that like you've got to be realistic with the setting up of the training week and what sort of considerations you need to make. So just trying to not let it get in my head too much, but moving forward, the thing that I'm really happy about is just accompanying my new setup with that, the position that I'm changing with. So heels in a little bit harder, just allows me to drive a bit more of that inner foot to the floor, which helps me keep my bum down and just feel myself pushing forward harder. So as you can see, the mat is slipping, I'm pushing that hard. So I've thrown down a 25 kilo plate for this next set, just to try and keep the mat still. And that way we can continue benching much more specific, like it's on a platform. So looking forward to that.
We seen the trap, nigga be on that demon clack. Resultantly, they fiend the clap as often as the genius at misquoting me. Meanwhile, I see that your diamonds is glistening. I'm glad that you shining, but need I remind you, my niggas is diamond and nickeling. Scraping on whatever coin they can find, a petty is trying to commit in it. Just to get by for a limited time, the steepest mountain they trying to climb. I'm here trying to find a derivative. You niggas don't feel me, you see the clout, you don't see the real me. If I was sick, you nigga wouldn't heal me, therefore I'm healing myself. Getting into it with my guys, slowly revealing myself, building my wealth. A nigga touch mine, I'ma kill him myself. Trust me. Everything come back around full circle. Why do lies sound pleasant, but the truth hurtful? Everybody gotta cry once in a while, but how long will it take for you smile? This is that come back to life shit. My niggas pick me up and we gon' light the city up as if the sun had the night shit. And paint the town red for my nigga found dead too soon. Now I know why they call it blue.
Alright, next one.
Wait, you've taken photos. Take photos.
Side chest,
boys. Pick a side.
Side chest.
Go there. Side tricep. Pick a side.
Anyway.
Go on, Dad.
All right, so that's a wrap for day one. I had a pretty good session, like considering we had the competition on the weekend, meet directing, hosting, and setting the gym up for the comp and then packing it up to go back to normal again. Obviously, like, sleep wasn't optimal over the weekend because I had to be here for weigh-ins early in the morning and whatnot. So I'm glad today went as well as it did. I'm pretty sure it's probably quicker than last week's squat single, which I'm really happy about. And even the back offs felt airy. So plus 5 kilos on last week. Can't ask for much more, which I'm really happy about. Like I was saying before, bench wasn't feeling as good as what it should be. But contextually, you know, I accept that because I know that I benched yesterday for my primary session. So I know benching, you know, competition singles back to back is not going to be optimal for me, at least. So I took it with a grain of salt that today and maybe even like up until probably Wednesday, my bench is going to feel as good as it was last week at this time. So looking forward mostly to tomorrow's deadlift. Kel and I agreed that probably a 7.5 kilo jump is probably going to be optimal week to week. Just trying to jump between RPE units. In previous times, I've always done 10 kilos, but I think I bite off more than I can chew by the third, fourth, fifth week. So when we start getting towards the back end of those blocks where we're doing like 30 to 40, 50 kilos difference from the first week, it just becomes too much and builds too much fatigue. So given that we're 7 weeks out now, we're probably just going to be a little bit more conservative and mindful of our fatigue and probably just going to take 7.5 kilo jumps. And then that way, I think I'm landing or finishing at 5 weeks out on a 3 12.5 kilo deadlift. And that should put me in good stride to start peaking. So I think, yeah, being at a 3 12.5 kilo deadlift to start a peak is pretty cool. So I'm looking forward to obviously capitalizing on more numbers during that last 4 week period of getting ready for nationals. But that'll do for now. I'm gonna head home. I'm gonna give myself some dinner. I'm gonna give this dog some dinner. And I'll see you guys probably in the morning, all right? Take care and chill out. What is up, guys? Welcome back to another day. I'm currently sitting in the car. And just left home. I'm on my way to the gym, but I've got to run a couple of errands first. I got a nice little package from Mr. James Lee with some Hyper-Vs. Sending them off to some good friends over in Germany. One of them is my client, Mike. If you're watching this, mate, shout out. You're about to get the receiving end of some Hyper-Keys. I'm also sending him a couple of goodies as well, just for obviously supporting the brand worldwide, which is fantastic. Got the dog in the back. Where is he? He's having a nap, but I've got Spencer sitting there. Got my fruits on deck. I've got some little cheeky Sour Patch Kids as well to fuel today's session. So I've got deadlifts, looking forward to it. As pre-discussed with Kel, going to be hitting a 297.5 single today, and that should put me in good stride for 305, 312.5 at the 5 week out period. So looking forward to that. And yeah, I'll take you guys for a ride. I'll see you guys probably at the gym next, and peace out.
Face is blue. Sugar sick as fuck. It's like I'm walking on the flu. Carol City, nigga, boy, I'm coming out the zoo. Boy, we coming out the zoo. Boy, we coming out the zoo. Boy, we coming out the zoo. Boy, I'm coming out the zoo. Rep your set, grab a tech, leave you wet and project. The cut like Gillette, where they serving, don't protect. Place a bet on your head, call your bluff and make a check. Guilty until innocent, far as I know, I'm heaven sent. Block 9x9, blow your mind. Now you Einstein, design in my prime to do time. Bitch, I'm Frankenstein. This is what you made me. Carol City raised me. Trick said I'm a thug, that's the hate you gave me. M's all on my belt, I'm feeling like a Majin Buu. Pocket full of Ivy and you know the face is blue. Sugar sick as fuck, it's like I'm walking on the flu. Carol City, nigga, boy, I'm coming out the zoo. Boy, we coming out the zoo. Boy, we coming out the zoo. Boy,
coming out the
So the biggest thing when it comes to doing like a leg accessory like this, fuck, are you right, mate? Showing your ass, everyone. The biggest thing to understand when we do an accessory like a pit shark or a hack squat or a pendulum or something, it's all good and well to like push them, but at the end of the day, if you're getting ready for a competition, you don't necessarily want to be pushing them harder than your squats, for example. So I've been sitting at 6 plates for like 4 weeks or something. I was doing like 8 and I backed it off purely just to, I guess, put a little more emphasis on performance through like my squat and my deadlift. So I've actually regressed this for the purpose of making my priority when it comes to performance and output those exercises, the SPD. So that's just a quick tip on like just making sure that you've got your ducks in a row when it comes to execution on accessories during a powerlifting prep. And secondly, another tip just with the belt squat in general, like being able to correctly replicate as best you can a squat pattern, similar to as you're going through a powerlifting prep, you want to make the program a bit more specific and make it something that replicates, you know, like a competition like day as best you can. So what I'm trying to think about here is everything that I do when I squat, getting my knees forward, feeling midfoot, making sure I feel my legs, ribs back as best as I can without the belt pulling me into extension. All those things are contributing towards the primary goal of getting better at squatting, right? So just remember that like, it's not just volume. It's not just, you know, making sure that you're growing. It's also more than that. It's from a motor and biomechanical standpoint as well. But yeah, hope that helps. Alrighty, well that wraps up day 2. Hope you guys enjoyed that. I definitely had a really good time. It always happens when I'm warming up for deadlifts. There'll be a distinctive point between like 230 and 260 where it just doesn't feel good. And I'm just like, righto, time to get a good kick up the ass and pull my finger out and have a proper crack. And that's what I did after I did that 260, I think it was. I immediately switched on. And sometimes that's all it really takes is for things just to feel a little heavier. And then that's just enough of, information for you to know that you need to really turn up now and start making this bar move. So I was really happy with tonight. Just being able to turn up and obviously lift 297 the way it was. And then bench went okay. I felt surprisingly all right, like considering I did my primary day on Sunday and then tempo yesterday and primary day again today. Usually I'd rest on Sunday, right? So benching 3 days in a row might be something worth discussing, Kel, because I didn't feel too bad. I definitely buggered up my second single at 140, just touching too low because my shoulder got elevated, but I think it's definitely something worth exploring, perhaps benching 3 days a week, 3 times in a row to get a good result, because I felt pretty good, especially after deadlifting and being in this position for God knows how long, many sets. But that's it. I'm gonna wrap up the gym, close it up, and last one here with Mr. Daniel Lee, and I'm gonna go home and actually, no, I won't lie. I'm going to say I'm going to go to Macca's and get 3 hamburgers and a medium chocolate shake, because every single Tuesday, that's what I do. I leave work and I go grab myself a little bit of a treat on a Tuesday night. So I'll swing by Macca's on the way home, sort myself out, and then I'll go home and I'll do some Tuesday night check-ins and get ready to go to bed. All right? But anyway, that'll do for now. I'll probably see you guys tomorrow. I've got upper body bodybuilding and look forward to speaking to you guys then. See ya. What up, everyone? Welcome back to day 3. Wow, okay, so day 3, episode 3. Here today doing some upper body stuff. I've had a really busy day. Leaving to Melbourne tomorrow at 2 p.m.
to fly down for the sub-junior, junior and masters national championships. So just didn't try and pump out as much work as I can before I go, because I know I won't be very productive once I'm down there, but I will be productive on the platform with my lifters. We've got 18 people going down from Hunter Performance Center, which is really exciting, and hoping to get the best result possible for all of them. They've all been training very hard, and yeah, just been busy writing competition plans, putting out some promotional stuff, obviously, and hoping to get a lot of support down there with local people and obviously on the live stream and stuff like that. But as for right now, just I haven't really ate much today. I had my breakfast, and currently just doing the thing that I did on Monday, where I just missed out on having lunch, and because I've just hasn't had time to be in the kitchen, and I've just got myself here nice yummy selection of strawberry jam bagels, so coated them with a bit of salt. Now I'm going to get into that, and then I'll suck back some water for about 20 minutes, and then maybe have a banana as well before I rip in. I've got young Patrick Stubbs coming in today to I guess train with me. We're going to do some 2-count pause bench together and some upper body bodybuilding stuff, because your boy needs it. But that will do. All right, I'll take you guys around. I'll see you soon. Here he is, Patrick Stubbs. Cool. Mate, the viewers been asking about you and want to know who you are.
Fucking hell.
Oh, mate, you love the camera, don't you?
No. Fucking hell.
You're my training partner today, aren't you, mate?
Yeah.
I'm going to get stuck in, yeah?
Yeah.
Fucking oath.
Word up, look out for the cops though.
Cash food.
Word up, 2 for 5s over here, baby. Word up, 2 for 5s, niggas got garbage down the way. Word up.
Cash food, everything around me, cream it.
Yeah, check this old fly shit out. Word up.
Cash food, take you on the natural joint. Cream it, the
here
money.
Here we go, dollar, check dollar bill, this yo. Shit. Yeah. On the crime side, the New York Times side, staying alive was no job. At second hands, moms bounced on old men. So then we moved to Shaolin land. A young dude, you're rocking the gold.
Alright, so did my top double at 7, which is 132. It actually moved pretty well. And Kel requested that I'd go up to 140 for an impromptu single, because everything is just moving along well. Since I benched that Sunday, it's my 4th day in a row actually. So could be on for just doing multiple bench sessions back to back to get the best out of obviously my bench press, but we'll see how we go, eh, Pat?
No question, I will flow off and try to get the dough off. Sticking up white boys on board boards. My life got no better. Same damn low sweater. Times is rough and tough like leather. Figured out I went the wrong rap. So I got with a sick ass click and went all out. Catching keys from cross seas. Rolling in MPVs. Every week we make 40 G's. Yo, respect my nigga, the tech notch. Bow, move from the gate now.
Cash moves everything around me. Cream get the money. Dollar, dollar bill, yo. Cash moves everything around me. Cream get the money. Dollar, dollar bill, yo.
It's been 22 long, hard years. I'm still struggling. Survival got me bugging. But I'm alive on arrival.
There you go. All right, boss's orders. 150 with my comp max. 4th bench day in a row. Who would have thought, you know? This is what it's all about with programming. You just got to figure out exactly what works, and this may be it. Benching 4 days in a row to get the best result. Who would have thought? Let's give it a crack.
Life as a shorty shouldn't be so rough, but as the world turned, I learned life was hell. Living in the world, no different from a cell. Every day I skate from takes, giving takes, selling bass, smoking bones in the staircase. Though I don't know why I chose to smoke cess. I guess that's the time when I'm not depressed, but I'm still depressed. And I ask, what's it worth? Ready to give up, so I seek the old earth. Who explain working hard may help you maintain, to learn to overcome the heartaches and pain. You gotta speak up, kids, corrupt cops and crack rocks and stray shots. All on a block that stays hot. Leave it up to me while I be living proof to kick the truth to the young black youth. The shorties running wild, smoking cess, drinking beer, and ain't trying to hear what I'm kicking in this.
And we're back.
I was just thinking,
got folded by 150, but I'm pretty happy to hit it today on a day where I didn't think I was going to come in and hit 150. And sometimes that's all it takes. Keller's been constantly talking to me about, you know, you'll know when it feels like to be on when it comes to doing SBD. I've never really felt on with bench at all. It's kind of just felt
the same every single session, but I've come in today and it felt on. Like the first time 145 has ever moved like that. Move 150, which is great. That's my comp best. So I'm just gonna work on some technical things off the chest and on the chest. So I'm gonna do some two count now to really emphasize that, like we didn't already know that. But yeah, pretty happy overall. I was disappointed after it, but that's just me being the athlete I am. I want everything to be perfect. But after reflecting, you know, hitting a comp best after doing obviously a lot of unspecific stuff, pretty happy with it.
Neglected for now, but yo, it got to be accepted. That what? The life is hectic. Cash moves everything around me. Green get the money. Dollar, dollar bill, yo. Cash moves everything around me. Niggas got to get the money. Dollar, dollar bill, yo. Cash moves everything around me. Green get the money. Dollar, dollar bill, yo.
Alrighty guys, well that wraps it up for day three, episode three. Hope you all enjoyed it. I definitely did. I benched my PR, which I hadn't done in yonks. So very happy with that. But yeah, I think Kel's probably going to put something together in the programming that's going to be in consideration of how I perform today. Because obviously, like I said before, I benched on Sunday for my primary day. I did tempo on day one of this next week, and then I did a primary day yesterday, and then I did an intuitive primary day today. So for me to work up and do 132 and a half for two count double as my pull, as my intended top set, I did 140, then 145, then 150. So very happy. I think the 150 can be better, obviously. Like stoked to have hit it because I hadn't done that in ages. But the thing is that there's some things that are still breaking down at that top end that I need to work on, such as getting a soft touch, ensuring that my ribs stay up, because I love to just do this when I come down, just burp, push my ribs back and close off. So lots of work to come, and I'm sure I can put something together to hopefully squeeze out an extra 2.5 to 5 kilos by nationals. But to be hitting 150 right now, pretty stoked. Off to Melbourne tomorrow, leave Newcastle at 12:30, arrive there at 4:30, so I'm going to take you guys with me. Going to train at some gyms that I haven't trained before, thinking somewhere like Pro Raw, or maybe even just train it in two, maybe even go see our friends at the Strength Fortress. We'll figure it out as we go. Obviously, there's a lot of people flying in from all around the country, so I'll just see what the vibe's like and take some people with me. We're hiring a car, so getting around won't be an issue, but I'm looking forward to seeing all my lifters kill it and just anyone representing Hummer Performance Centre. I'll be there all weekend. I'll be there every session. I've got clients and lifters from the team in every category you can think of. So I'm excited to hopefully turn up and claim a couple more of these banners. So that will do, all right? I'll see you guys in Melbourne. If you could like, comment, subscribe, and share this video, I would absolutely appreciate it. It's gonna help us grow and obviously share the Hunter Performance Center experience with you all right? And that will do. I'll talk to you soon.